Bob Schrum, in your book, No Excuses, you say some things about Senator John Edwards that have created some discussion, and the Edwards campaign has weighed in. I want to talk about one specific instance, and that was his vote on the Iraq War.
Right.
And this is what you write. That fall of 2002, as a vote loomed on the resolution giving Bush authority to go to war in Iraq, Edwards convened a circle of advisors in his family room in Washington to discuss his decision. He was skeptical, even exercised about the idea of voting yes. His wife, Elizabeth, was a forceful no. She didn't trust anything the Bush administration was saying. But the consensus view from both the foreign policy experts and the political operatives was that he was just too junior in the Senate. He didn't have the credibility to vote against the resolution. To my continuing regret, I said he had to be for it. As I listened to this, I watched Edwards' face. He didn't like where he was being pushed to go. The meeting did him a disservice, of course. He was a candidate, and if he really was against the war, it was up to him to stand his ground, and he didn't. Senator Edwards is now the first candidate who voted for the war to acknowledge it was a mistake.
Right.
When his campaign learned you were on the program, they sent this statement. Bob Schrum's thoughts about Iraq had zero influence on Senator Edwards' vote. The meeting Schrum describes in his book was a meeting about domestic political issues in which several people offered their opinions about Iraq to Senator Edwards. Unfortunately, in Bob Schrum's worldview, the only conversations that matter are the ones he's personally involved in. That's not the truth, of course, but Bob and the truth have had a rocky relationship for a long time, and this book is no exception. What's going on?
I guess they don't like the book, and I'm not going to respond in kind. Look, that meeting happened. That meeting was about the Iraq War. I'm not suggesting that John Edwards or John Kerry or anybody else went out and voted for that war on purely political grounds. I'm suggesting that the politics they talked about may have shaped and influenced the lens through which they saw and weighed the issue. People have cherry-picked that book about John Edwards. I talk in that book about meeting him in 1997, calling my partners and saying, I just think I met a future president of the United States. I think that may still be true. He's the man who put poverty back on the Democratic Party agenda and the national agenda. I'm sorry they kind of overreact that way, but John Edwards himself confirmed the fundamentals of what I said in one of these early debates when he said, what I learned from the whole experience was to put more faith in my own judgment. Well, what was his own judgment? I think it was an inclination to be against the war.
When in 2004, you had to make a decision to work for John Kerry or John Edwards. You opted for John Kerry.
Yes, I think it was the right decision.
Why?
I think John Kerry was the best prepared person to be president. I think he was the person who had the best chance to beat George Bush. And although we always forget it, and we administer a ritual beating to our defeated Democratic nominees, unlike the Republicans who kind of rehab candidates over and over again, John Kerry came very, very close to being the first person to defeat an incumbent president renominated by his own party in time of war.
Why isn't he running?
He's not running because he told a joke he shouldn't have told last November, and he got beaten up very, very badly about it. I don't know that he would have run, but that precluded him from running. We're going to take a-